Welcome back. Fino here with a guide for the Queen of Sheba exhibition quest. She's found a way to turn money into armor like a certain Valkyrie Drive character. She starts the fight with 15 stacks of a money wall buff. This gives her huge damage resistance, and to get rid of them, you'll have to play a little game. She'll actually buff your party with stuff like NP damage buffs, crit damage, attack, defense, and so on. Each is a one-time buff, and if you successfully use them as she doles them out, you weaken her barrier. But with Sheba, there's always a catch. Sheba collects interest at the start of every turn, meaning the carrier gets a debuff and she gets stronger. In a way, you're playing Simon Says. With that in mind, I'll go over a few of the more notable debuffs. If you can't use the crit buff, your NP damage goes down. If you keep the NP damage buff, your star gen goes down. And if you can't use the invincibility, you lose a buff while Sheba gets a debuff cleansed. The first two I picked because they're the ones you're the most likely to fuck up. Critting on demand requires some pre-planning, or 20-30s, and if a support caster or mash is stuck with the NP damage buff, there's no physical way to pay it back. Sheba just gets free crit chance. As for the invuln, your punishment is pretty nasty, so you should brace yourself if you can't pay it back. I'll also note that the attack buff gives Sheba defense if you fail to pay it back. In sufficient amounts, this will make the fight unwinnable. The next notable feature of this fight is that Sheba will summon a pair of debt collectors. She'll revive them at every break bar, adding a Yakuza and then a Thug in that order. If you leave them alone, they pester you with their active skills. Thugs can stun you while Yakuza charge up Sheba. For the record, the Thugs can purge buffs on their Noble Phantasm, which is pretty damn annoying. The Yakuza get sure hit on theirs. Killing these trash mobs might seem pretty tempting, but they have nasty on-death debuffs. The Yakuza will put a 10-turn buff block on someone. Same for Thugs, except it's a 10-turn taunt. As you start popping Sheba's bars, she'll gain 5 more stacks of money wall at each phase change. She also increases the number of buffs she gives out, and adds more types as well. This means that by her final bar, you're juggling so many balls, the situation's almost guaranteed to spiral out of control. With these factors in mind, I strongly recommend you take your time on phase 1. If you clear out the initial 15 stacks of money wall, you can deal with the remaining 10 opportunistically while you burn Sheba down. By the start of phase 3, you're pretty much on a timer, and winning fast is critical by that point. To account for these factors, I'd run a somewhat defensive frontline with Kentoki Rider as your anchor. As a quick, single-target Rider, he can fill the conditions for the phase 1 buffs, while also being a strong finisher. To back him up, you can run characters like Mash, support casters, just something along those lines. You'll be taking some NPs and you want to shield Toki from the trash mobs when you can. Speaking of which, I generally avoid killing the debt collectors, but if a depleted support gets too many loan buffs, you can run them into a thug to force a taunt and pretty much guarantee their death. Alternatively, you can use the plug suit to send them away since buffs don't tick down while servants are in the backline. When you're ready to finish the fight, you can arrange multiple consecutive golden drives, especially if you can fit Scotty onto your backline. Alternatively, Meltrilis fills a similar role if you happen to have her. Despite the fight having so many little details, the core idea is really just Simon Says, with an FGO coat of paint. In that respect, I think it's reasonably fun despite the RNG, since your team composition is pretty flexible while it tests your resource management. As long as you do the bulk of your work in phase 1, you should be able to get a clear without too much trouble. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Like if you found this video useful, subscribe for more FGO guides, and come watch me on Twitch where I stream every weekend, 3 p.m. Pacific time, Friday through Sunday. The Guild Fest is on the menu this week, and I'll see you there.